Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. Happy Tuesday, or actually it is Thursday for you, so happy Thursday, but I hope you had a great Tuesday as well. Today we are jumping into some Amazon favorites, which I love doing these videos. I only get around to doing them like 3 times a year though, because I have to take time to accumulate products, you know, like I don't go and buy everything at once and share with you guys all of these products. I kind of buy them gradually over the course of a couple of months, and then when I finally have enough things to share with you guys, I scroll through my Amazon orders and pick out the items that I did enjoy, and then I go and gather them around my house and share them with you guys. So that is what we're doing today. I'm sharing with you some Amazon favorites. These are things ranging from kitchen goods to home decor to organization, DIY tools. And if you are curious about anything I do share in this video, definitely check the description box below because I'm going to have absolutely everything linked. I also, you guys, put on a self-tan yesterday, which is very unlike me. Do I look glowy? I don't know. Tell me in the comments. I'm like nervous about it. I don't know why, but I put on a self-tan. It just seems like fun. I haven't done it in years, and I am just so pale, and I can't tan because I have red hair. I'm a ginger. I cannot tan. I just turn red. So let me know what you guys thought of my little self-tan. So the first thing I want to share with you are these vintage kind of brass inspired frames that I found on Amazon. Now, I personally love these frames. I love finding them authentic at a thrift store or at an antique shop. I found a couple actually at an estate sale a while back, but they were still pretty pricey. I think they charged me about $30 a frame. And so I went on Amazon because I needed specific frame sizes for my entryway makeover. And I actually featured these in that makeover video, but I didn't really touch on them. And I wanted to touch on them today. So I pulled them off the wall, brought them upstairs. They're really cute, you guys. Look how stunning this brass frame is. I just love it. Now, of course, it's not real brass. It's definitely like a plastic, but it gives you that look for less, of course. So we have this one, which this one is my personal favorite here. Then we have this smaller one, which was also on my gallery wall. I love this one as well. I like how it's very kind of shapely. And then last but not least, we have this one, which I actually didn't end up using in the wall, but I did order it. And I'm gonna keep it in my stash because it's super cute. Like I could so imagine this above a toilet with like a little landscape artwork in it, or like above a bed, or just something mixed into a gallery wall. I just love these frames, and I had no idea you could buy like similar looking frames as the antique ones that everyone uses in interior design, because sometimes it's hard to find them. It's very hit or miss. So if you do need one for a project, check out Amazon, and I'll link all three of these below for you guys. Next up, we have a set of coasters, and yes, I do not need any more coasters. I literally share a set of coasters every time I film these videos, but something about purchasing coasters to me makes me so happy. Like, I feel like it's such an easy price point to sometimes be like, oh, I don't need another coaster set, but you know, it's only $10, so I might as well just pick it up. This set was so cute, and I've been seeing like cottagecore vibes trending a lot lately, and look how adorable this little rattan kind of cane coaster is with a little scalloped edge on it. They're actually crafted so nicely. Like, they're very, very sturdy and strong, and they're perfectly shaped as well. And on top of that, there's a little plastic piece on the bottom, which allows your drink to not, of course, get on the surface, which is great because it could easily totally soak through that cane there, and you get a set of four. Let's just dive on into a couple of DIY supplies very randomly. I have two of them here to share with you guys. The first one is a new contact paper, and I am someone that when I come across a contact paper that I think is cute, I just order it because I know I'm gonna use it in a future project. And this one did not disappoint. I loved the way this contact paper was dark. First of all, I have zero dark contact papers. They're all very like white based with pink or brown or black, whatever it might be inside of them. And I loved how this one was dark. I also loved how it was navy, and I love how chunky and like luxurious this marble pattern looks. I feel like chunky marble is really trending right now in home decor, so I figured I'd pick up this roll of contact paper so I can use it in future DIY projects. I did a project where I took just some wood blocks and turned them into a marble bookend set. So this would be a great option if you want to create your very own marble bookends. Like, this would be such a pretty marble bookend. And then this right here, you might be asking, Drew, what is this? And I've only used it once so far, but it works amazing. And I know I only have used it once before, but I have a different one that I've used for 10 years. It is a heat tool. I share it with you guys on my channel all the time when I'm doing DIY projects. And a lot of you guys are always like, that's not a heat tool, that's a blow dryer. But it actually is a heat tool. It is a Tim Holtz Ranger heat tool from back when I used to do scrapbooking. However, I feel like it's just outdated. It is legit 10 years old, I'm not joking you. So I wanted to upgrade to something a little bit stronger. And if you've never used a heat tool before and you are a DIYer, I highly suggest splurging on one. This is only like $35, but it speeds up the drying time of any project. So if you're painting and you need multiple coats, you can heat gun it up. That's what we call it, heat gunning it. I'm like, let's heat gun up this vase. It's fully dry in a couple of minutes. You can apply a new coat, heat it up again, and it is dry and ready to go. So I use this all the time when it comes to drying projects for videos or drying projects in general. Okay, here's a cute little decor. Now this decor actually came totally different than how I expected it to come. I purchased this thinking it was going to be a tabletop vase, and I wanted to originally put this on my media console out in the living room. I thought it would be really cute with, like, you know, like a little plant coming out of the top. That was the whole vibe. So imagine this just like on a little wooden media console, but then it got here and it's wall mounted. But the thing that I love is that I've never ever seen a wall mounted version of this before. I have seen hundreds of these like Grecian goddess heads that are like planter bases, and I know I could get them anywhere. So I purchased one on Amazon because it was the cheapest option, and then I realized that it was a wall mounted one. But I think it's really cute. I'm gonna keep it in my stash for sure because I could totally find a use for this in the future. And I love the color of this one as well. It's kind of like a grayish sage, but it has the slightest bit of distressing on it as well, which I quite like. And then the nail hole in the back allows you to hang it on the wall and use it as just a really cute wall planter. Okay, I finally broke down and bought a new kitchen set. It looks like this. It's so heavy. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna drop it. I've had the same exact kitchen set for, I think, since 2014. It is a Dwell Magazine times Target collab. It's like a silvery one. I wasn't even into interior design when I bought it. I just thought it was cool in itself. And I've had the same one forever. Never have purchased new plates or bowls ever. So I decided to go ahead and splurge. Well, not really splurge, because you get four full settings with four pieces in each setting for $40, which I thought was such a great deal. And look how cute these are, you guys. They're like ceramic. They have a little matte finish on the bottom here, and then like the top of it has a speckled glaze, which I love. And the bowl is just such a cute shape. I love it. And then we have, of course, the little salad plate and the dinner plate as well at the bottom there. And I just thought that these looked so nice, and they were super simple, so I can add whatever I want whenever I'm doing place settings or anything like that. This is just like a very simple base that you can add to, but it still has some interest to it. I like the little matte glaze section at the bottom here. Very random, quick little item I want to share with you guys. This spray paint here. This is the Rust-Oleum American Accents Stone Textured Finish. Now, I personally am not a fan of this color. Way, if you could see that up there, it's like a taupe with black and white speckles in it. Not cute for me, I don't like it, but I do like the texture that it gives off. So you can spray this on any vase or any project at all, and it gives a chunky texture. Let it dry, then spray a new coat of paint over the top of it, and you get that texture underneath, but you get your new color over top. So I like using this as a sprayed base. I have yet to film a project. I've used it, of course, in the past, and I've used it on personal projects and things, but I have yet to actually film a project with it. So it's going to be on my channel very shortly. I'm excited to use this. I hadn't used it in a while, and I ordered a new can of it, so I can definitely share projects with you guys, but it's a great can of spray paint. I am a coffee table book addict. I love having a ton of different coffee table books around, and yes, I actually do look at them. I look at them quite often, but the thing is that for my Instagram and my YouTube, you guys, I am constantly restyling spaces to share with you guys new ways to do things, and having the same books in the same spaces over and over again just kind of gets boring to me, so I love having options on hand. It just comes in handy, you know, when I want to style something. So this one was cute. I love the color of it. It's like a yellowy kind of unsaturated tone. Something about this book just mixes eclectic with like on trend very, very well. Sometimes I feel like coffee table books can be really outdated. It's not something that is constantly being updated. It's like one book that was made 6 years ago, and you know, some of those styles aren't around anymore, or trends have changed. However, this book I feel like really, really encapsulates like a lot of things I've been loving lately. There's lots of arches in here, neutral tones, like very eclectic textures, and just all around there's really fun stuff in this book. So I highly suggest this if you're looking for a coffee table book. It's also a substantial size, and it looks really cute on the edge too, so you can style this on a shelf or wherever you want to use it. And again, the content inside is amazing, so all around a great coffee table book. This is a set of mixing bowls. I personally have had the same exact one mixing bowl. I've had one mixing bowl since I've lived in Los Angeles for 7 years. It is that big round IKEA stainless steel bowl, and I just realized I need more. Like, I'm constantly using little small bowls just like this to like mix things in randomly here and there. So I decided to purchase a mixing bowl set, and this is a nesting one. But the thing I love about this nesting set is that each bowl has its very own lid. So as you go deeper down, you could take the lids off, and you get different colors. They're all so cute too. Like, look at the little last one. They kind of ombre from cream to green. The thing I love is that you get like 6 different sizes. Each of them have a lid. So if you're mixing something or you're serving something, whatever it might be, you can pop the lid on, store it back in the fridge, and you are good to go. You don't have to transfer it to a Tupperware or anything. A throw blanket that is just sitting right next to me, which I love. This is probably my favorite throw blanket I've ever purchased online before, because most times I just buy them in stores so I can kind of see what I'm getting. But I saw this one and the pattern was really intriguing to me. I just thought it was a perfect mix of kind of like interesting but neutral, but woven, full of texture, has tassels on the end, and I just like this blanket a lot. It looks so much more expensive than it actually costs, and if you guys can see the actual texture in the weave, it's really nice, but it's still soft. A lot of times with these woven blankets, they're not soft, they're kind of more itchy and decorative, but this one is nice, and I love how one side kind of features more white, and then the back side kind of features more black. So depending on what colorway you want to go for, you have 2 different options there, and it's just a substantial blanket. So this next thing might look a little strange. You guys are like, what is that? Now, this is a really cute little plant stand, or just like a little pedestal that you can really use anywhere. So I wanted to go ahead and use this actually in the shelf in my dining room and put like a plant on top of it so that I can then, you know, elevate the plant a little bit and give it a little bit more interesting detail. But something else I thought that would be really cute for this is to put it by the stove and like put your olive oil and salt and pepper on there, or most use like essential items. Or you can even put it in a bathroom, you know, put soap and then lotion on here. I just think it's really universal and it's also affordable. And the other thing I love is that it's raw wood, so you can totally stain this or change it up however you would like to do so. Okay, something else that I swear no one talks about is vase fillers. Like, vase fillers are so hard to come by, and I see all of my favorite interior designers and people on Instagram posting these insane arrangements inside of vases, and I'm like, how did you even do that? Like, where did you get those? So I went online and I found 2 different vase fillers. Now, one of them is like overly expected, like one that I really, really liked, and then one of them is just not as expected, but I still like it. It's cute, and I'm gonna share both of them with you because I have them here. So the first one, which I like the most, is this one. I think this is so pretty. Imagine if you got a couple of these as well and you kind of put them in a vase and filled it up. However, one is so full. I actually put one of them in the jug that you're gonna see in the overlay clip, and it just looks incredible. I find it so hard to find really full vase filler, because if you have to go to Joann's and, you know, buy individual pieces, they're like $10 a piece. And the other one is actually just sticks. They look like this. They came in this box here. I actually have, it came with like triple the amount here, but the other ones are in the vase out in the living room. And I just kind of adjusted them a little bit to where there was like a bit of height. You can kind of shove them into each other like this and just flare out some of the branches so you get a bit of interest. But these are just simple sticks, and I believe these were pretty affordable. Again, you could probably go outside and just break these off of a tree if you wanted to, but I thought I'd share them with you because I did end up putting them in a vase and they do look exactly how I wanted them to, but it did take a little bit of finessing. I thought they were gonna be a little longer than they were, but they weren't. But you know, I'm gonna make it work. Do not worry. And then the last thing that I want to share with you guys are actually these little glass containers here, and they have little lids on them with a airtight seal. Now, my friend Erica from Peony and Honey actually posted on Instagram that she had bought these specifically for her supplements and vitamins and pills and things, and I just love that. I immediately went on Amazon, bought the same pack, and I did just exactly what she did. So as you can see here, I have my ashwagandha, which is great for anyone who's anxious. It's like a natural mood booster. And then I have my daily vitamins from Ritual here. I'm gonna put my Advils in one and just put all of my supplements in these little jars. They're airtight, so it's perfect for them. And all around, I think it's just a cuter way to display them as opposed to having a lot of different pill bottles in your cabinet or things like that, you know? So I just like this, and you get 12 of them in the pack as well, so you get a generous amount, but you can also totally use these for craft supplies, whether it be, you know, little paper clips or safety pins or just little small things you could use to store them in these as well. And I just like the idea of making a label for the front so you know what's in there. And yeah, I think that is everything I wanted to talk about. I'm looking around to make sure. I think we covered it all, and I want to thank you guys so much for watching today's video. And if there was something that you did like, definitely check the description box below for all of the links for everything. And I will just catch you guys in my next one. If you also have anything that you have been purchasing lately, whether it be from absolutely anywhere, totally let me know in the comments below. I love seeing what you guys are buying, different things you find online. Online shopping is a habit of mine, so there's that. But I will catch you guys all in my next one. Have an amazing rest of your day, and I'll see you next time. Bye, guys. Thank you.